30 years ago this month, the start of a 51-day standoff in Waco, Texas, captivated the world. It centered around a religious sect of the Branch Davidians, run by this man, David Koresh. 76 people, including 25 children, died in a raging fire. Now there's evidence the mysterious cult leader was following the teachings of another cult. NBC2 investigator Evan Dean follows the path from Estero to Waco.
Alongside US 41 in Estero, in a busy, ever-growing area, there's one place that remains unchanged. It's a place trapped in time. What remains of the cult that once called here home?
1894, a man named Cyrus Teed found this land and brought his followers down to build a commune. They were religious utopians, they were celibate, and they believed that they lived inside of the earth.
They were called the Koreshians. What's left behind is on this land or in the archives at FGCU. Professor and author Lynn Milner says Cyrus Teed believed in a hollow earth and believed he was the Messiah, taking the name Koresh.
Koresh is the Hebrew transliteration of Cyrus. He believed he was King Cyrus from the Bible, and he believed that he was the Lamb from the Bible that was sent to save humanity.
He wasn't. After Teed died, the cult went into decline. The land was eventually given to the state, which turned it into a park. But as it turns out, the small cult from our corner of the world had a bigger influence than once thought, an influence far beyond Southwest Florida.
Very much so.
Without Cyrus Teed, I don't know what would have happened in Waco.
Power over the adults in that facility. We were doing what we thought was best to try to prevent this tragedy. I'm accountable. The buck stops with me.
They made the decision to immolate themselves, and I regret it terribly, and I feel awful about the children.
It was 1993 near Waco, Texas, a weeks-long standoff between an apocalyptic religious group and federal agents ended in tragedy, a fire at a compound that claimed dozens of lives, including children.
The ATF raid and the FBI siege of the Branch Davidians at Mount Carmel has had an impact that's lasted 30 years.
Author Jeff Gwynn's new book explores the actions of the ATF and FBI, and the rise of cult leader David Koresh, born Vernon Howell. Among the revelations, that Koresh's prophecies were plagiarized.
The genesis of this is in Fort Myers, Florida. I was able to come to Fort Myers, use these archives, and in them find in Teed's newsletter, The Flaming Sword, word for word, 100 years almost before David Koresh ever surfaced, all the same prophecies that Koresh would later use.
Gwynn discovered it was one of Koresh's predecessors, Lois Roden, former leader of the Branch Davidians, who discovered Cyrus Teed and fed Koresh his prophecies. But how? Turns out, Teed's followers published a book after his death. It is extremely rare and hard to find, but Gwynn found it in a tiny library in Waco.
And again, the writing in it is exact. There is no question that word for word, David Koresh was basically citing Cyrus Teed, not the angels of the Lord.
During the standoff in 93, Gwynn says a religious scholar had identified the connection, says it could have changed everything, but blames the feds for not doing more with that knowledge.
If the FBI had been open enough to listen to Dr. Phil Arnold, who originally discovered the possibility of the link, there would be some people alive today, probably, who died on April 19th, 1993.
And not just that. What happened here 30 years ago inflamed a distrust in government. Wynn wonders what else may have never been had the standoff in Waco not ended in tragedy.
Some of the most traumatic events in recent history directly derive from it. We can't understand the attack on the Capitol or things happening today if we don't understand Waco.
The same thing's happening today where we're not talking to each other. If they're two opposing sides, there is a deep misunderstanding and a refusal to talk. Everyone was clinging to their beliefs. We're doing it now. And you see there can be even deadly results.
Reporting for the NBC2 Investigators, I'm Evan Dean.
All new.